Let's write down the properties. Properties of the Laplace transform. So, for example, integration, that's happening quite often in analog circuitry. So integration is, if you have something like f of tau, obviously d tau, so if you have something like that, in Laplace space, this turns into 1 over s f of s, so essentially integration turns into a division operation. So then the differentiation. So differentiation. So it's just d over dt and then f of t. And this must obviously balance out the s here. So that's then obviously a multiplication operation. So let's introduce something which is really important for our digital signal processing later on, and that's the shift operation. So if we have something like f, which is t minus capital T, so that's our shift here, then in the Laplace space, this is the multiplication with an exponential e to minus ts, and then f of s. Oh, shift t missing here. So how can we prove that? So let's say, so we've got our Laplace transform here of this h of t minus t, and then this is running per definition from h of t minus t e to minus s t dt. So that's our definition of our Laplace transform here. So now we do the trick, what we've done already before. So we move this t in here. And we can do this because per definition our h is causal. So we have no trouble with that. So we write h of t. And then e to minus s and then your t plus t. It looks a bit odd here. So it's a t dt. So then we see here we're getting a constant factor here, which is just this e to minus ts here, which we can just move out here. So then the integral runs again from h of t and then e to minus st dt. And this is here obviously just the normal Laplace transform here. Laplace transform of h of t. Yeah, so then therefore we are getting this shift operator here. So this one here. Okay, so we've proven that. So let's now check if the convolution. The convolution works in the same way as with our Fourier transform for the A causal signals. So what you would like to have is, if we have two signals x of t multiplied by y of t, so that if we transform this into our Laplace space, so x of s, that this turns into a multiplication. So that's what we would like to have. So that's our Laplace transform, Laplace space here, and this is here time domain. So convolution, remember, is defined as h of t equals from 0 to infinity, and then f of tau g of t minus tau d tau. So in the next step, we just need to prove this, that this actually turns into a product in Laplace space. So remember, what you would like to have is that we have a function like f of t convolved with g of t, that this turns into f of s multiplied by g of s. So how can we prove that? So remember, our convolution is something like that, from 0 to infinity f of t and g of t minus tau d tau. Yeah, so this was our definition. In this case, we just start with 0 here. This makes it easier for the proof, but otherwise won't change our result. Okay, so how do we prove that? So we just write this basically out as a Laplace transform here. So we have our Laplace transform, which is running from 0 to infinity, so as a variable t here, so then e to st minus st. Now we just write our convolution inside here. So tau equals 0 to infinity, and then f of tau, and then gt minus tau d tau dt. So the general plan is here just to reshuffle this here, reshuffle that, we get two Laplace transforms. As a product. Okay, so let's do that. So let's write this on this new sheet of paper back on here. So our h of s is from t equals 0 to infinity e to minus st. So that's our Laplace transform, and then we put our convolution inside here, tau equals 0 to infinity, and then this is f of tau, and then g of t minus tau d tau dt. So the crucial point is here that this t variable here, this goes in here. So the integration is, the inner integration is influenced by the outer integration here. But what we can do is that we just move both integrations to the outside. Yeah, so that we do this here, so that we have a double integral here for the time being. And then we've got the f of tau g of t minus tau dt. Okay, so now we just change the order of integration. Change order of integration. So now the problem, or the difficulty is here, what we need to be careful is of this dependency here. So this dependency reverses. Yeah, so what we need to do now is, so we've got the tau equals 0 and this runs to infinity, and then we've got now the other one here, the t, which is running, starting now at tau, and is running to infinity. And so the rest is the same. So st, and then f of tau, and then this is g of t minus tau dt, and then d tau. Yeah, so now we've got this nasty tau term here, which is not nice. And so what we're doing is we are creating a new variable. So we are creating t bar, which is t minus tau, and substitutes this in. So, and this obviously, if we do this here, so we are getting rid of this here, of this tau. So we've got just t here. We are getting here plus tau, because we're shifting everything here. And this turns nicely into zero here. So the only problem is now, so what is our dt bar? And this is just dt, because in this case, tau is a constant. Yeah, so therefore we can rewrite the whole thing like tau equals 0 to infinity, and then the other one, our t bar equals 0 to infinity here, and then e to minus s t bar plus tau, and then f of tau and g of t bar dt bar d tau. So in this way now we have two integrations here, and we can just separate them here, and we already see this is coming towards our Laplace transforms here. So let's just write this here down again. So then we have our integration here, tau equals 0 to infinity, and then the other integration from t bar to from 0 to infinity, and this is e to s, and then t bar plus tau, and then we've got here the f of tau and the g t bar, and then the dt bar here and d tau. So now we can just separate these ones here and separate the integrals, and so then we are getting out here tau to 0 infinity, and then this is here e to minus s, and then we've got the tau from here, and then this is here f of tau d tau, and then this we are just multiplying this here by the second integral, so from t bar to infinity here, and then this is e to minus s, and now we've got the tau here. Is this a, no, that's a t bar here, t bar going in here, and then this is our function g of t bar here dt bar. So and this is here the Laplace transform of f, and this is here the Laplace transform of g. So let's summarize the convolution. So convolution. So if we have something like f of t convolved with g of t, then this turns into f of s multiplied by g of s. So let's say the convolution operation. And this is here in the time domain. And this is here in the Laplace domain. Laplace. This turns into a multiplication. So that's a very important property, and you should keep this in mind.